Zapraszam. Crowd, get along. You're lucky, guys. This is wonderful. Tell me, did the girls actually... There are many of them, I know. Tell me, did the girls react like this everywhere you appear or only on Comic-Con?
Yes.
Well, I was gonna say no, but... Maybe have different experiences about it.
Usually girls run the opposite direction from me. They see me and they're like, oh no! And they run.
So I have, we have a different case over here.
Yeah, very much.
I didn't see so many phones up. Oh, sure. Okay, tell me guys, how did your adventure with teenage drama begin? How did you approach the role? Did you look for something like that? Or did the opportunity just came in? Henrik?
You know, first of all, we're both teenagers, so it's really natural for us to go into the teen series genre, if you call it that. I don't know, I felt like I stumbled into it. My first project was a real grown-up drama, and we were only small kids. But doing a teen drama, you're actually a big part of a teen gang, and you can call it gang, it's more like a crew. And it's much more fun, I must say. It's a better experience.
Okay, for you?
Yeah, when I first got into it, I think it's just kind of natural when you have a younger looking face and you're a younger person starting off in acting.
We both look very young.
Yeah, I look like I'm 14. So, I think that like when you have a certain look and you're first starting out, I think naturally you kind of start to gravitate towards teen-leaning shows like ours. Yeah.
And when you approach a script, are you looking for this kind of roles, or you, this is the one that they are offering you because of your looks?
Yeah, I would say that like it depends on, you know, how old you can play and where you go. I don't think, at least personally, like I don't seek out specifically teenage roles, but if they come to me and I, you know, I appreciate the writing and the script, then I'm glad to do it. Because it is a certain kind of acting, a certain kind of work that it requires, you know?
Yeah, I definitely agree with you. It's, as we said, very natural for us to do young parts, but we also enjoy teen dramas, I can imagine. So it's fun to actually be a part of something that you're going to watch yourself and enjoy.
Yeah, definitely. Like I definitely found that for Riverdale, I'm such a huge fan of the show itself. Like apart from me, if I wasn't in it, I would still watch it. So then to become a part of this thing that that I appreciate and I can share that love with everybody was an amazing experience.
So you started about Riverdale. So follow up. This question. You said you were a fan, but you knew that the thing from a comic can grow so much that the whole crowd would come here to see you? When you approach the Riverdale, and it's based on a comic book, so you can also know that it's a small group of people that actually know the source material, and it will grow up for being a new teenage drama?
Yeah, it's funny. I'm a huge comic book nerd. Like, I've grown up loving all kinds of comics, just reading them, and getting to kind of take something that has a more niche fan group like the Archie Comics and bring it to literally millions and millions of people worldwide is an amazing experience. We really like grow this community of people that love the show and are introducing them to the original source material. I'm honored to be able to be a part of that.
And you also, when you were coming to the cast of Skam, it wasn't in the beginning, so this show was already on and everybody was talking about it. So what was your reaction when they offered you to be part of the cast?
Oh my god, that was crazy. I remember screaming in my living room out of joy. Because, as you said, this was a big show in Scandinavia until the third season. And then, look at this. Now there's fans in Poland. You could never imagine that. So thank you so much. And it's so great to be a part of a series that actually touches people and gives them something more than entertainment. That's a big experience.
And taking part in such a show also means from you to show more emotions, to play with them. Is it hard for you guys to find to find the power also to, you know, switch from one emotion to the other, because it's very hectic sometimes.
Yeah. I can take that. Well, that depends very on how the director works. If it's a hard feeling, if you're going to something hard, like I remember the scene from the locker room with Isak and Evan, where Evan tells Isak, I'm dumping my girlfriend, let's go. And just to find that feeling, it was so hard, so we almost did just that scene the day. I think we took like 30, 40 shots.
30, 40 shots?
Yeah, because she really wanted to be natural, real, as we're saying something that we really mean. And just to get to that feeling is a very hard mental progress.
But isn't it like this, that when you repeat this scene over and over, it starts to be less and less real because you start to do it mechanically?
Of course.
I didn't mean to interrupt you. I think it's all part of the work, you know, like when you're approaching a scene where you have to be, you know, very emotional and you have to switch from emotion to emotion very quickly. I think it's all part of the training and the work that goes into acting to allow yourself to be open and vulnerable to moments like that, right?
That's so true.
Yeah, and it does, like, I think it can be tiring when you do repeat something over and over again, you have to do 40 takes, which is crazy.
Yeah.
It can be really draining emotionally to open yourself up like that so much, but it's all worth it to get a good scene, you know? Because you know that feeling when you kill a scene,
of course,
and it's like amazing. You just walk away, you're like, yes!
That's so true. But that's the greatest feeling, but also a great feeling is when you actually do 30 takes.
Yeah.
And you're trying to get into something and the director doesn't feel like you're doing it right, or this isn't his vision. And then you get really frustrated.
Yeah, definitely.
Which line was I going to choose?
Right, yeah.
Am I going to go more from this, or am I going to do less or more of that?
Right, yeah,
so
it's always finding like
that. That's the part of the training that you have to come through. You have to do this. You have to be ready to do this 50 times.
Yeah, definitely.
Until the director is happy with your performance. And but that's so true.
And then you're checking it on the TV screen. Which take did they take, and did I nail it?
I do that all the time. Yeah, I'll be watching it, and I'll be like, I hope they used that really good take that I liked. And they never do. There's like one take that you love, but they never use it. They'll use a different one.
We actually had a whole different thing about that in Skam, because the actors weren't allowed to actually watch a lot of the clips, because they don't want us to go into ourselves and be like, why am I doing like this? Start fixing yourself and doing stuff that you weren't supposed to do in the first place. So we actually couldn't see that until we were done with filming.
Yeah, yeah.
And if it was a great scene, it was like, you have to come and look at it, watch this.
Right, yeah, yeah.
And it was so magical.
Yeah, it's a good feeling.
It's a very good feeling.
Okay. No to w takim razie teraz przejdziemy do pytań publiczności.
Halo, jestem. Okay. Ze mną dwie dziewczyny.
Chciałbym przypomnieć, że jeśli chcecie zadać pytanie, trzeba się tam ustawić za panem z mikrofonem. Okay, first question.
When you said the script for Riverdale and read about your character, what your first reaction?
So when I read the pilot for Riverdale, first reaction, I didn't believe, like, so, spoilers for anybody who hasn't seen it, my character's dead.
No! Yeah. Spoiler!
I die right away, and so when I read the first episode, I didn't really believe I was dead. Like, I was reading the script, and I'm like, no, I'm gonna show up at the end, I'm gonna be, like, hiding behind a tree, or something, but then at the end of the first episode, they find my body. And I was like, oh no, okay, I'm actually dead. That's cool. I'm like, that's fine. But it was an interesting reaction, you know. I immediately started wondering where the story was gonna go and who the killer was.
Did you get the whole script and
Yeah, I got the pilot, I got the whole script once I booked it, and but I didn't get anything past that. You know, like, there's a mystery in the show that I didn't know the answers to the mystery until, like, the last episode. So, they kept me in the dark.
But you know, this is a comic book. Everything can happen in the later series.
No, it never happened in the comic books.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying, that everything can happen. Because it's something that's dramatic thing, you know. It can bring you back in the other flashbacks or anything, so.
Yeah. Thank you for your question, I really appreciate it.
Alright, next one, please.
Like, what was the best memory?
With who you
get along with the best. So, who I got along with the best on set? I mean, I got along with everybody. Everybody, the whole cast is amazing. But my buddy Rob Rocco, who plays Joaquin on the show, him and I were pretty tight. Like, we hit it off. So he's a really good friend of mine. And as for my favorite memory, I would have to say it was probably for episode 5, Cheryl's nightmare, where she sees zombie Jason like reaching out for her. Filming that scene was so fun that I will never forget that.
And the question was my favorite memory and...
Who do you like play best on the show?
I get along with it. It's a good question. I'm that kind of actor. No, actually, we all got along very well. And some know this, but it was a very small group. So we always hang out together. We had a lot of get to know each other things, like go out in theater, go out and eat something. Especially me and Tarai, we did a lot together just to get to know each other. Because we were going into some scenes that were really hard to be comfortable with each other. So I must say, I connected best with all the boys, like the boys squad and everything. We hang out.
The boys squad.
Yeah, that's what they call us. And we hanged out almost every day for a week. So that was probably my best memories, just being at Nissen at the school that we play this. And just being the whole crew, doing different scenes, running around from classroom to classroom, and just being with each other. It's very nice.
One Thank big you. Happy family.
One big happy family.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Hey, I have a question for you, Trevor.
Okay.
You are dead.
Yes.
And your story is not your to tell.
Right.
So how do you feel with that as an actor? Character that, you know, your colleagues have to create?
Yeah, that's a really, really good question. it's an interesting experience as an actor, because you're right, like, I die right in the beginning of the show, and even though my character plays in a really integral and essential role in the story, I myself am not around all that much, right?
I don't understand anything.
But it's still a really, really good experience, right? Like, I may not have been able to, like, craft this character and tell this story through my own work, but I was still I saw myself as a part of a larger story, right? And I got to learn more about who Jason was with each new episode, right? Every new episode would inform something about who he was in my mind, which would then let me, which would allow me to prepare the character more and more. And I really got a lot of joy and meaning out of just having a role in this really well-told story, and getting to be a part of it, which that was what I took away from it. But that's an amazing question. I really appreciate it.
Thank you. Next question, please.
So hi, this is a question to yourself. What's your favorite scene that you played? Love you.
Like my favorite scene in general, or my favorite scene that I'm in?
That
I'm in? Yeah, I mean, the most fun I had was shooting the zombie Jason dream, but I think my favorite scene is actually the one you see right at the beginning of the first episode with Cheryl and Jason driving down the road and then walking to the bank of the river. Every time I see that scene and the music is playing, I get chills. Like, I legitimately, I just think it's beautifully shot and the music is so well done. That's probably my favorite scene that I was a part of. It's just that iconic opening scene to the show.
I must say that my favorite scene is probably the Uhelga Nat scene. When Isaac is at the church, runs away from his family, and goes to listen. And that scene is just so magical to me, because we were there, we actually saw what happened. This scene is very, like, mellow, kind of sad. They meet in the end and kiss and, like, make up. And in the background, it was playing this disco music from the restaurant from across the streets. So we were, like, trying to be emotional. It was like, right. I love you. It was so much fun because we had to retake it 10 times because I came out and Isa was coming towards Evan, and we just heard the music and looked at each other like, we gotta do it again. So it was kind of fun to play the scene, but it was so magical when we actually saw the scene with the beautiful music. So, goosebumps, really, yeah. Thank you.
I recognize you.
The big question of who the Black Hood is. I think it's Hot Dog. Definitely Hot Dog, Archie's dog. I think he's definitely the mastermind behind all of this. Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Hi.
Hello.
Thank you. Oh, that's so pretty. Okay.
Never ever a woman reacting on me like that.
Do you have any new proposition to play
Do I have a series that I want to play? Is that what you're
doing?
Or
yeah.
Do I have anything
do you
coming
want,
up?
You're asking both of us? What was the question again? What kind of series?
You were sitting there chilling.
Yeah, I was thinking about what you said. Sorry. What was the question?
I don't... You know, there's nothing really that I can talk about now that's coming down the pipeline in regards to being in another series for me. Nothing that I can discuss. But anybody who knows me knows that I'm a huge, like, superhero and comic book fan. So, shot game. Anybody out there wants to cast me as a superhero in anything, just let me know. I'll talk to my agent. We'll make it happen. So,
I just see you as a Marvel superhero or something.
Thank you.
Well, I want to play your brother. The evil brother.
Spider-Man's my favorite superhero.
Me too.
Thank you.
Sorry, Ben is already taken.
I know. Tom Holland does a great job, but he took my job.
You're too tall.
I might be, yeah, he might be a little bit too tall.
And you?
I'm gonna say as much as you did, actually. Nothing that I can discuss right now, but I'm looking forward to doing, I really want to do movies because I've only done TV series. So, for an actor or actress, it's a big leap story-wise.
Yeah, to go from TV to film. Right.
So, I think that's my next goal. But I'm not going to say no to a good TV show. So, it's hard to say what's going to happen
in
this business.
I mean, exactly. Like, it's always as actors, we're always in a transitory position in our careers where we're never sure exactly what's going to happen next, but there's always going to be opportunities that we can take hold of.
Right, and in this business, you don't actually know that you're going to work until you stand on set.
Yeah, exactly.
And even then, you don't know it's going to come out. So
right, yeah, so.
It's stupid for us to discuss something.
It's always up in the air.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, so we have two questions. The first one is, do you currently, and do you still have contact with other people from Skam, and who is it?
Yeah, good question. So as we discussed earlier, we're still very good friends. So some of them don't live in Oslo, but we often try to meet up. So the people I see most is like Ulrike, Marlon, Tarjei, and we've become very good friends actually. It's great.
And Trevor, do you prefer season 1 or season 2 of Riverdale?
That's not a fair question. They're both great. I mean, I'm partial to the first season because I'm in it. But I mean, the thing is, our writers do such a good job of crafting amazing stories that I can't get enough. I honestly, both seasons, season 2 so far has been coming out really great, and I'm really invested in that mystery. And then I think season 1 is such a well-told story in and of itself that they're great. I can't say a favorite. They're both great.
Thank you.
Hello. I have a question for you, Henrik. By the way, I love you.
Oh, I love you too.
I love you too.
Lots of love for you.
I want to know, how did you get into this car? Like, what's the story behind you?
The audition story?
Yes.
The long or the short version? What do you think?
No, we don't have time.
Short version? So I was a struggling actor, you know, working 3 jobs. No, but actually I was in a really low part of my career where I was not optimistic about anything because I was turned down, like, it's between you and him, and it always got the other guy. So I always felt like, maybe this isn't something for me. Maybe I'm not that good, you know what I mean? So, and Skam was running on TV, it was a huge hit in Norway, Sweden, Denmark. and I really wanted to be a part of it because I could see that these actors are having so much fun. They're exploring their acting and friendship. So I think that was something every Norwegian wanted to be a part of. So there was like 5,000 participants in the auditioning. And I was actually the last one who came in the door. That's the long story. But then, as Julia said as well, it just clicked. And that's sometimes how it feels when you walk into a room and it's like, this is right. So from there it was like, I went to audition on Monday and we started filming on Thursday.
Wow.
So I had 3 days to prepare my Evan, which is a very... it's a character with a lot of sides to it. Mm. It's a hard character to play. And on top of struggling actor, two jobs, it was hard, but when you do something you really love, like acting, you get so much energy from doing it. So I could work 5 jobs and still have an acting job on the side, just getting energy out. It's so great.
Yeah, it definitely fuels
you. Right. Thank you so much for the question.
Thank you.
First of all, I love you so much, and I'm a very big fan of yours.
I love you.
And I thought that your hair is more red. And getting to the question, what is your favorite scene in general, like from all scenes?
Okay, so my favorite. For those of you who don't know, my favorite band is Imagine Dragons. And there's a scene in the last episode of the first season, episode 13, where Believer, right, is coming. And there's this scene where Betty and Jughead are getting it on. And they're interrupted by the serpents and they like give him the serpent jacket, right? And he like, there's just this moment where he like throws on the jacket right as the music like kicks in. And he like looks back at Betty and just the look on his face. That's my favorite scene. Like, I can't even talk about it without getting goosebumps. Like, it's so good. Shout outs to Cole and Betty, or Cole and Lily for killing that scene. That's my favorite scene in the show.
I have a question for Trevor.
Mm-hmm.
When he was watching Riverdale, yep. We realized that Cole and Jason were in the same class.
Yeah.
But Cheryl.
Okay, yeah, I know what you're gonna ask, but okay.
But Cheryl is Jason's twin sister, mm. And she is in the same class as Betty, but Holly is older than Betty. So can you tell us how it's possible?
Yeah, okay, so. I hear about this a lot. The answer is don't think about it. I'm just kidding. So, I believe. What the actual logistics of the situation is, Cheryl and I are twins, but I think Betty's sister is just older. She's in an older class, and I'm just dating an older woman in the show. I don't think Betty and her sister are not in the same class. Her sister is older than me, so that's how it's possible. We can put those questions to bed now.
They're tough questions, man.
Yeah. Ask the writers, man. Just kidding, yeah.
Okay, thank you. Thanks, love. Please.
Yeah, so I guess my question is for both of you. And it's sort of different. So, how's Poland so far? And do you try, for example, when you maybe some Polish cuisine? And if so, did you like it?
It's cold.
Yeah, it is.
It's a little cold.
Winter's cold.
Not compared to Norway.
I guess it's okay.
Well, I've never been to Europe before. This is my first time, so...
You know it's not one country, right?
Is it?
It's not one country.
No, I've never been to...
I was kidding, because most Americans think that
Europe is Europe. So this is your first time in our continent?
Yeah, I've never been overseas.
Yes, so you're very welcome.
Thank you, yeah, and I'm glad that Poland is the first country I get to visit here, because it's
amazing. And the crowd get wild. So did you try any food, guys?
I did.
I've had some chocolate, some Polish chocolate.
We actually went to a Polish restaurant last night. What was the name of it? I don't know. But it was... Transformer, that's right. I don't know what it means, but...
Cheers. Not Zdrowie, cheers.
No, it's Skoma.
A gospoda. Gospoda. It's a tavern.
A tavern. Right, it looked like a tavern. And it was wonderful. We ate dumplings and some... what do you call it?
Pierogi. It's pierogi, it's not dumplings. Dumplings are Chinese. We are pierogi.
Get it right.
Sorry, sorry about that.
Learn it, man!
No, it was wonderful. Yeah. We're really enjoying ourselves.
Yeah, definitely.
I'm glad.
Beautiful country.
Yeah, thank you.
Okay. Next question, please.
Hi. What would your perfect character look like? I mean, personality. I love both of you.
Perfect character?
Yes.
What would your ideal character look like if you had to play a character? What would you look like?
I think I don't have an ideal character for an actor.
Batman.
Well, Batman has been played by like 10 guys. You're just in line. My dream character is something that's maybe hard to wrap your head. Something more complicated.
Enigmatic.
Like, the more you work on a character, the more interesting it becomes. So it all depends on how the writer works and how the director works with the script and the actors. So there's a lot of different factors that comes to mind.
Yeah, I would echo what Henrik said. It's definitely, I think my ideal character would be something complex that it really takes a lot of work to dive into. And a lot of just meaty emotions to pull out of you, you know? Like, any character that allows me to be open and vulnerable in the scene work and in working with my other actors and the director, that's my ideal character. It's anything that really allows me to be open and tell a story in an emotional way, you know?
I will remember that you turned out Batman. Okay, guys. Niestety, tutaj już pokazują mi, że musimy kończyć, więc zapraszamy was. Dobra. I unfortunately have to tell them that we run out of time and I try to take him for tomorrow panels.
We can sit here all day.
Yeah, we could. I'm down to sit here.
Let's just chill here. Yeah. We're going to the next question.
Okay, last question. Last question.
So
I love your costume, by the way.
Thank you.
That's amazing.
I want to say to Trevor that I love you so much.
I love you, thank you. That, I am so glad that I got that question. Look, it's the perfect cookie, okay? Oreos are the perfect food, right? Exactly, the ratio of like chocolate cookie to cream is perfect. They're just delicious, I don't know, they're amazing. I love Oreos, man, me too.
They pay you for the advertising or something?
I'm not sponsored. Oreo, if you're out there, sponsor me. Send me some free Oreos. Honestly.
Okay, dziękujemy wam bardzo. Thank you very much, guys.
Hi.